Hey, my name is Ben and I teach you how to write Unity shaders from scratch. Today we're going to do this hue shift formula. As you can see here, we're shifting, hue shifting this texture. It's going to be based off of another texture, or it doesn't actually have to be. It can be done without it as well, right? We can have control our saturation as well as our brightness. Okay, so the setup we have for hue shift is quite simple. We have a main text and a hue shift texture, as you can see right here. We have three property variables, a hue shift, a saturation, and a brightness. Right now, they don't do anything. I've set some ranges that I'll explain in a bit. And our shader right now, all it does is we're using this hue shift. We're going to put all of our math in here. We're passing in the color of our main texture, so the color of this texture right here. And right now we're just spitting out one. So if we change this to zero, it will change to black. So let's use this as our current setup. Okay, so today we're gonna do hue shift using YIQ. What we're gonna do is take our RGB values from our fragment shader, convert it to YIQ, and then back to RGB. Generally how hue shift works is this. We take our RGB values, we convert it to YIQ, Y being the luminance, so brightness. IQ is a vector 2 that signifies the color. Hue shifting, what it does is really, it just kind of takes a variable along this Y, and then let's just say it rotates it along this, actually it goes this way, rotates along this image, and it shifts the color. So here it would be shifting to green, orange, purple, magenta, blue, and back to green, right? So hue shifting is using one single value and shifting it along this color wheel so that our colors will shift to other colors without losing Y, Y being luminance, right? So we can change to other colors along, imagine just taking a color wheel and kind of spinning it inside our shader. Now, the one we're going to do today is going to be a little bit lengthy, but it's a little bit easier to understand and explain. Of course, it can also be condensed to a much simpler format, just taking the math and just condensing it down to something simpler, but we're not going to cover that one today. So the first thing we need to do to convert from RGB to YIQ is use this matrix. And at the same time, we're also going to take this matrix out, which is converting from YIQ back to RGB. So let's go ahead and enter these values into our shader now. All right, so I've gone ahead and copied over these values for YIQ to RGB, as well as RGB to YIQ, as you can see these two right here. Now, to do our very first conversion, we want YIQ. So let's do float 3, YIQ is equal to, we're going to do a matrix multiply, right? That's what's happening right here. A mul against our RGB to YIQ against our color that we passed into our hue shift. That's it. So if we display our YIQ, this is now, should be in the correct colors, or in YIQ space. It doesn't really do anything. If we try to shift it, it doesn't work. But I do think this is what we want. So now that we have our YIQ, what we need next is our hue. So to get our hue, we're gonna go back to this image. Imagine we have our Y set to somewhere out here, okay, where my cursor is. What we need to do is have the angle between I and Q so that we can shift it along this. So let's get our hue out and then let's shift it. So to do that, it's gonna be float hue is equal to do an angle between these two vectors on this circle, it's arctan, arctangent 2. And arctan is a little bit strange where you have to pass in the Q first, the Y first. When I say Y, I meant the Y axis. Usually things are done in XY, but when it comes to arctan, it is a little strange. You pass in the Y first and then the X axis, or in this case, the Q axis and then the I axis, right? Once you have this hue, you can also add on our hue shift. Oops, not here. Right, we can also add in our hue shift here. Next, we need chroma. This is kind of like saturation, right? So if you look at this carefully, here it's a little bit gray because Y, I believe here, is set to 0.5. So it's like half saturation. And here it's full saturation. We need our saturation amount so that we can recalculate going back to RGB. So it's usually called chroma. And to do this, what we need is the length. Yeah, so for chroma, let's just go ahead and use a length, and we're gonna create a simple float two. Oops, float two. It's gonna be IQ. Remember, just make sure it's reversed of this. Think of our I as our X axis, right? So length of this, and that should be it. Let's go ahead and spit out the chroma. I wanna see if it's actually gonna become, no, it's not. Of course, there is no I and Q here. What I meant to do is, so Q would be the Z axis, dot Z, right? I is in the Y here, so dot Y. All right, there we go. So now, since we're spitting out chroma, we're spitting out black and white. If we spit out hue, you probably don't get much data from this because we still haven't changed this back into RGB, but chroma should be kind of a black and white version of our image. All right, let's go ahead and reconstruct our RGB values. So what we want to do next is reconstruct a new I and a new Q. Our new I is going to be chroma because we need our length. And what we want to do is multiply it against the sign of hue. Yes. We want to do the same thing for I, or sorry, for Q, but it will be cosine. Going back to our image here, what we want to do is have the new I and Q shift along this this plane here. So now if we display our new YIQ, you know, since I've done I and Q, you know, we might as well also make Y because we need to reconstruct this thing anyway. And our Y, remember it's related to luminance, will be YIQ dot Y, no, sorry, dot X, the first value, plus our brightness, which we've created up here. All right, so let's reconstruct our YIQ. Float three. We already have YIQ here. This is going to be the shifted one. Shifted YIQ is equal to float three, Y, comma, I, comma, Q. We're almost done. If we display this, it's still not it's still not working yet, but our hue shift should start to change the values. Our brightness should change the brightness of our texture, of our image, and our saturation doesn't work yet. Let's kind of get that working. So for saturation, what we need to do is simply multiply it. Cool, so now that we're in YIQ, we have a shifted YIQ. What we wanna do is change it back to RGB. So changing this back to RGB, we're gonna use our matrix. So we're gonna do float three, new RGB is equal to mul this value against our shifted YIQ. And I hopefully that should change it back to RGB. Okay, let's change our brightness back to the center so that everything looks quite right. Let's give our saturation one and let's put our hue shift back to zero. So there's a slight error here. Our I and Q are flipped. Q should be doing cos and, I should be doing cos and Q should be doing sine. Okay, there we go. Yeah, as you can see, from if we set our hue shift to zero, it should be our original image. Our saturation should be able to oversaturate and desat completely to black and white. And our brightness should work as black and white. Yeah. Our brightness, you can convert this into contrast if you want it as well. All right, let's set everything back to normal. The last thing we're going to do is we're going to add this hue shift texture. And what we're going to do is use this to drive to offset the hue shift. And to do that, it's actually quite simple. All we got to do is pass in a hue shift here. So we're going to pass in hue. We're going to pass in float hue. Nope, let's not use that. Hue shift. Yeah. And we're just going to replace this hue shift here. And now here, we're going to pass in underscore hue shift. So if we do that, it should behave the same, right? But what we can do now is also sample another texture. Normally what I would do is put this texture in the alpha channel for this, but for the sake of this demonstration, I'm just going to grab the hue shift texture, which I didn't even make yet. So let's quickly do that. We'll just use the same UVs. And then we have our hue. And then what we want is, we can do this as a fixed, and we'll just do the R value. No, we'll do hue shift plus hue. So now we can have it offset differently, and we can have different images drive the hue shifting of this texture. It'll probably look better if I used something else here, let's say maybe grass, and then we have some grass that looks kind of, let's say, old, I guess you can say. And then you can use different textures to drive, you know, where it looks kind of, you know, dry, I guess you can say. Yeah, so that is going to be it for this particular video. I mean, if you guys like what you see, please do like, subscribe, and support my channel. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye now.